Hey guys, it's Barrett with the Gimpy Camper. So I wanted to talk to you today about de-winterizing the camper. Like I told you on the winterizing video, that link's going to be up in the corner here. You know, I do this process about every other weekend in the wintertime. And because if I'm paying for this thing, I'm going to use it. We're going to take it out. We're going to use it. There's not a lot of snow and ice and that kind of stuff around here in Southeast Tennessee. I like winter camping better than I like summer camping. It's nice to hang out around the fire, not be all humid and hot. Right? So basically this is the process that I use to de-winterize every other week. And I'm going to take you step by step through there, and we're going to show you how easy this is and why it's just beyond me why anybody would pay somebody to winterize or de-winterize their camper. So once you understand these basic concepts, it takes 10 or 15 minutes. It's easy. There's no reason to go pay however much they charge. I don't even know how much dealerships charge. I'd say it's a couple $100 for 15 minutes worth of work. That's going to be faster for you to do this, even if you got to do it once a season, than it is for you to drive to the dealership and wait. I'm telling you, there's no reason you can't do this. In order for me to de-winterize this, the first thing that I usually do is put the anode rod back in. And that is the biggest pain of all. So you have to have a socket or wrench to do that. It's easier with a socket with a small extension. It's a 1 1/16. I had to buy this just for this purpose because it's kind of an awkward size and most people don't keep one of those laying around. All right, guys. So the reason this is hard to put in is not because of anything about screwing it in, but it's all this weight back here. So what happens is you're trying to screw it in and it has a hard time not cross-threading there. Occasionally you want to change this Teflon tape out. If you do this every other week like I do, no, I don't do it every time, but it had a small leak last time. If I forgot to mention it, the first step in all this is to hook the water up or fill your tank up. So we're going to put some new Teflon tape on here. You know, the leak was pretty small that it had last time. But given the fact that I only have this 60 gallons of water to last me all week, I don't want to lose any of it, okay? So we got our new Teflon tape on there, and then we're just going to screw it in. So we put our plug in first, which you don't necessarily have to do first. That's just my order. And then you want to go around and you want to turn your pump on if you're using your tank, or you know, if you're not using the tank, then it doesn't matter about that. And so you want to turn the pump on because I'm using the tank, and you want to go start flushing the air out of your lines. I usually start back here at the outdoor shower as long as it's warm where I am. If it's cold, then I don't flush this line. I just leave it be, because I figure no air gets here. Now whenever I go, when I winterize it, I always come back here, even if I don't use the shower. So we're gonna go out here, we're gonna get our hose, we're gonna turn this water on. You're gonna hear air coming out first. Oh, it's a little bit faster than usual because I did use the water inside the camper last night, just the cold water, to use the toilet. Usually you'll hear air for about 30, 40 seconds before it comes out. We're going to do the cold and the hot water on all the faucets. So that's the hot water, a little bit of air. Now I do still have the bypass turned on, so this is all just one basic water system of cold water right now on the hot and cold. And then we're gonna fill the hot water heater up. But let's go inside and do the kitchen, and I'll meet you in there. Okay guys, so then we're gonna do the same thing in the bathroom, the faucet and the toilet and the shower. So I won't drag you through all that, but that's what I'm gonna do now. And now we're gonna turn the bypass off. So this is our water bypass. We're just gonna turn it to off. You're going to hear it filling with a little bit of water, and then we're going to go back inside. So the first few times I did this, I just used the release at the top of the water heater to fill the water up in the tank. But it was kind of hit or miss, and for some reason it didn't really just want to flow in. So after I turn the bypass off, I come back to the sink and I turn the hot water on until it gets all the air out, which means that the hot water tank is full.
Not forget to hit that subscribe button.